वेलकम बैक गाइस। आई गॉट फायर गार्ड एपिक वेपन फैंटम कैटलिस्ट। लेट्स इक्विप इट। द यूनिक एबिलिटी ऑफ द वेपन, सक्सेसफुल अटैकिंग एन ओपोनेंट विथ कामास, फायर गार्ड जनरेट शैडो एनर्जी। द डिफेंस इज इंक्रीज्ड बाय 5% एंड शैडो डैमेज इज इंक्रीज्ड बाय 10%। ओपनिंग स्टांस होस्ट एक्टिवेशन, विक्ट्री पोज इटर्नल स्लम्बर। Let's jump into the talents, friends. At level 10, I'm going with painful burns. At level 8, I'm going with effective flamethrower. At level 6, shadow flames. At level 4, earth on fire. And at level 2, raging flames. The attack damage is 441, defense is 482, and shadow damage is 567 at maximum level. Let's jump into the opponent. I tried playing 3-3, friends, but didn't got any opponent. So I tried 1v1. The first opponent is Fist, level 12. He started with Helga and I started with obviously Fire Guard. Round 1, post activation, fight. The problem with 1v1 is that, friends, many times in the place of real opponent, bot comes. I make sure that I will show you fight with real players, friends. I think in this video one opponent is bot, friends. The last opponent is bot. Just wanted to show you the bot's behavior in 1v1, obviously. Rest are PvP, player versus player. Perfect way to dodge Shining Dash. This time it's connected. Opponent is bit of annoying. Weapon looks good, friends, but its unique ability, it's shame. Fire Guard talent is he can regenerate shadow energy on its own. He don't need Kamas to generate shadow energy, friends. Still, the 10% boost to shadow damage and 5% defense is good, and that's Helga finished, friends. As you can see, the slow motion, the painful burst always does his job. Let's jump into round 2. The 1v1 is basically, friends, depends on our capability. It's a challenge. Different heroes versus different heroes. And we have, if we lost first round, we have chance to come back in second and come back in third. Shining Dash connected. And perfect counter for Fire Guard, friends. Helga, anti-hero. I will make sure that I will defeat this Helga. I think this round I will not survive, friend. Yes. Let's jump into round 3. 20th weapon in the game for me, friends, out of 29th weapon. Out of 10 epics, I got 7 epics, only missing Kate epic, Trenchant Obsidian, Kibo epic, Scarlet Vengeance, and one more epic for Monkey King, friends, that is Flawless Jid. Rare weapon I only missing for Jack Bulwark, friends. Rest, Scalpel for Azuma, AO Gongon's Gift for Monkey King, Shadow Razor for Marcus, and Multichrome for Cobra, friends. I am missing these rare weapons. Let's do heavy. Yes, it's connected, and I think this Helga is nearly done, friends. Yep, Helga is in an afterlife. Few more seconds of surviving. And I think the round ends up in a draw, friends. Pretty cool, no? Yep, it's ended in a draw. Pretty good match. No one wins. The next is NSG Exoblade. He started with Sarge, is gone with Revenge for the Fallen, Experience, Hammer Throw, Unstoppable and Will Destruction. I am obviously started with Fire Guard. There is no 3 vs 3, there is 1 vs 1. It's nice to review Fire Guard the Phantom Catalyst in 1 vs 1, friends. I got me. And I think yes, this Sarge is done, friends. Look at the effect of painful ones. Let's jump into round 2. Missed by shadow move. Fire guard means fire, friends. I don't want to depend on its shadow move. The fire itself can cause pretty much damage. Let's grab him. Oops, missed my chance. And I think one more hit and I think this Sarge will be done, friends. Yes. Let's jump into another opponent. As you can see, the amount of trophies is pretty low, friends. The next opponent is Baki. He started with Colonel Azuma. It will be going to be nice match, friends. Fire Guard versus Azuma. Post activation. Fight. Oops, messed up there. Let's, yep. Look at the damage of painful ones, friends. Shadow move also connected, followed by jump kick, and this Azuma is done. Yep, choked himself. That was pretty nice, friends. Let's jump into round 2. The good thing about next round is, friends, everything started new. No advantage of the first round. Like if you have full shadow energy, it will be not available in round 2. Okay, I started with flamethrower, it's connected. Oops, I thought my basic will connect. Let's do my shadow move one more time, friends. Oops, my neutralization got me. There is another flamethrower. Yes, heavy connected. And I think, oh, he dodged it. And this Colonel Azuma is done. Next opponent is Bot. I think, friends, just wanted to show you the difference. If we win from Bot, their trophies will not minus, only our trophy will increase. Bot chooses Helga with Shining Determination. Fight. First I thought it was a real player, friends. Then after finishing the match, I saw that it's a bot. The eye icon in the middle shows that it is real player. If it's not available, then it's bot. I think Helga has having repentance, that's why I was knocked out. Special connected. Let's try flamethrower. Bots anticipates our next move pretty fast, friends. They know what we were going to do. Helga is in our afterlife and her standing dash also connected. And round one won by Fireguard. Let's jump into round two, friends. Neki need to change the unique ability of this weapon, friends, Phantom Catalyst. If it's a epic weapon, they should give some invulnerability option to Fireguard or some more thing. Like Flame Bears having painful burns, opponent burns longer talent. Similar talent should have been applied to Phantom Catalyst. Otherwise it's a useless weapon, except that Fire Guards gain 10% shadow damage and 5% defense due to his epic rarity. And I think this Helga is done. Look at that slow motion death, friends. Okay friends, the video is coming to an end. I hope you like this Phantom Catalyst review. Feel free to comment about it. I will meet you in another video. Thanks for watching, friends. Goodbye.